So, I didn't get a chance to say this, but I'm gonna have to say this with a happiest heart in my life, and I'm gonna have to say this. Happy belated birthday! Happy to PlayStation 1, your 21st birthday, and correct me if I'm wrong, but it's a happy belated birthday, 25th birthday, Super Nintendo. Yeah! I'm really surprised that it is that both Super Nintendo and PlayStation 1 made significant impacts of gaming. Well, same goes with the consoles up that of the two that were sharing with the Super Nintendo and PlayStation 1. So Super Nintendo is what I gamed since I was a boy. And I really love gaming that much. And if you're asking me about what about the Game Boy? Game Boy is a big runaway success story of handhelds. GameCube, Atari Lynx, Neo Geo Pocket. And I'm not even going to talk about that Tiger.com handheld. That one was a complete garbage. No handheld can be Game Boy. But going back to the subject of PlayStation 1 and Super Nintendo, I have been playing Super Nintendo since then, and I got my games to share, and I have been collecting a bit of a game for quite a while, so, this is gonna be I'll be back. I'll keep in mind, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle is on it as NES. I'm gonna get that one out as well. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. My cousin Eric and I played this just recently, and we beat it before midnight. Something that my cousins Eric and Hal have not done it before midnight. It's very good. That game was really arcade feel, and it's really lovable and it's replayable, and you can have fun with just two players because you honestly. You cannot beat hardest mode alone. You'll die a lot if you play single player. This is Goofy True, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah. Yeah, keep this in mind. I'm gonna have to put this. Goofy True. It's made by Capcom, as with the other games. The story is about Goofy and Max going to rescue Pete and Pete Jr. from the pirates. I watched it on video. I don't know what was that about, but if watch chat on World of Long Plays titled Goof Troop. That one was lovable. Foggy Rocky 2. that was a sequel to the original Pocky Rocky. I have not gotten this from eBay yet. The Hook. Obviously, The Hook. If you can see it. Yeah. That was a game based on the Hook movie by Steven Spielberg, and starring Robin Williams. Yeah, it was based on the same story as the Hook movie, with Rufio, I don't know if it's spoiled. Just watch the movie first. And then played Hook. They're both very unlovable. Star Fox. The original Star Fox. It is the first of its own franchise, and it has a special FS chip. It's a rail shooter. It's Fox saving Corneria. The Lyland system from Andros story, just play it yourself. Super Bomberman! I beat all my cousins. I even beat my sister's husband on this game. I was very good at it. Okay, I got my own list of games I really wanted to play. Try. I did try Ultraman. It was very clunky. It's a slippery. It's based on a television series called Ultraman. Let's see. This. Magical Quest. I have played this. I don't remember what happened. I was really bad at this game as a kid. I struggle a bit more than the sequel. That one was hard. Animaniacs. I played this game a plenty. And it's made by Konami. This game is relatively different from the Sega Genesis. This one is more of a platformer, whereas the Sega Genesis version is more of a puzzle. Oh, I remember. Oh yeah, Kid Klown and Crazy Jace. I played this as a kid. I tried playing it as an adult and I completed it, but I didn't complete like a first loop, because that was extremely difficult, hard as balls on that one. It was a good running and trying to stop a bomb from blowing up. This one, Super Bomberman 2. I played that one multiplayer with my cousins. I actually owns them all. Ramen 1/2, Hard Battle. It's a fighting game. It's not like Street Fighter. It's much more simpler than Street Fighter, to be honest. But it's not real. It wasn't as tight as with Street Fighter, and that voice acting, that English voice acting. Oh my goodness, that was so funny. Super Mario World. I played this a lot as a kid. My little sister get to play it a bit. I actually enjoyed this game a lot as a boy, and I think I enjoyed it now. Mega Man X. This is not the original. This is not the one I own. I got this from my father when I was little, when I was very young, through eBay. That game is a big step for the Mega Man franchise to show its gritty, dark future of the Mega Man world as opposed to the classic Mega Man series. I played Mega Man 7. It was much more lighthearted than the rest of the Mega Man sequels. Yeah. Super Mario RPG. It was a beloved classic RPG. You can download it on the Wii and Wii U eShop. It's very fun. I could not have said anything better. Legend of Zelda. Extremely good game, and one of the best, my personal favorite Legend of Zelda games. I played it as a kid, could not finish it then, and then come back later as a high schooler and finished it. Yeah. Good accomplishment. Miss Pac-Man. I played it as a kid. It's the same as an arcade version, but it's you select your player mode and what you can add you can select the stages and whatnot. Yoshi Island. This is after Super Mario World, and this is a prequel. When Mario was a baby, Yoshi first met Mario, and it's about Yoshi bringing Mario to get reunited with his brother Luigi. It's a very lovable game. But the crying part makes my ear hurts. Tiny Toon Buster Busts Loose. It's a good platform, to be honest. A very fun game that I like. And including mini games. And the music, it feels like you're in the Tiny Toon world, and that's something that drives. I watched a couple of episodes as a kid. I love that. Space Invaders. I played that game. My cousin used to beat my ass on that game. I got mad. To my cousin's joy, he was laughing and enjoying the fun of it as a little boy. I actually grown out of it. Donkey Kong Country. I played that a lot as a kid. Very good game. I played Donkey Kong Country first. I played Donkey Kong Country 3. And then I played Donkey Kong Country 2. Oh no, wait, I played Donkey Kong Country Returns, and then I played Donkey Kong Country 2. Yeah, that was... It was made by Rare, and it was... And their quality was... It shows how far they were pushing it, like, the limitations of Super Nintendo on this game. And this is lovable. Super Metroid. Whoo! Nothing says better than Super Metroid. It's extremely creepy and really lovable. It's about Samus going to Planet Seas for the last time. But I'm not gonna spoil it, but you have to play it through just to see it.
Yeah! Got to do my parts.
Mickey Mania. It's not bad. Not bad. It's a platformer. It's Mickey Mania, made by Sony ImageSoft. Wow. I couldn't imagine why it changed that much. Batman Forever. That game was... I could not finish it. It took me... I got stuck, and I don't know what to do with it. It's made by Acclaim, which unfortunately closed. Super Mario Kart. That game... My cousins used to beat me all over again in battle mode. And what I would do as a kid, I would just try to reset or do anything. Or I just quit midway as my cousin kept on winning through the races. But it's a good game. Luckily, as an adult, I was able to outgrow it. Earthworm Jim 2. I enjoyed it a lot as a kid. That was fun. The music does
a bit more serious than the one with. It does feel like a bit of a good synchronization, whereas the Sega Genesis version is much a bit it had more grit in it than this.
Bonkers. A good platform. It's based on a Disney cartoon, which unfortunately it hadn't come into light. I love Bonkers playing. I played this as a kid. I loved that one. It was really fun. Not bad. Jungle Book. It's based on a movie. The animated one, not the recent movie. It's not bad. It's made by Virgin Entertainment. Yeah. This. The Great Circus Mystery starring Mickey Mouse. I really enjoy this game. I play it with my little sister, and it is very enjoyable at best. It's very nice to spend time together with my sister, because I have nothing else. I got this on Christmas. It's a different from Sega Genesis and Game Boy Color versions. It plays more like a platform where you have hearts. The Sega Genesis Game Boy Color has lamp with a smoke on it. So keep that in mind. This play different from what the versions had to offer. So keep that in mind. Donkey Kong Country 3. I said that one before. It wasn't as impressive as the first two, or Donkey Kong's Return and Tropical Freeze. This one, it was not bad. Not a bad game. Super Mario All-Stars. Wait. I got something else to share with. It looks all different now. I'm not sure what to tell anymore. Better than just. This is basically all four NES games. Like upgraded to Super Nintendo level. It's very enjoyable. The levels and the music is just on par. It holds up well to even at the Super Mario's All-Stars Limited Edition one. That one was the Wii. It even holds up well. I wish they would just release it to
the Wii U as a bonus. I wish they would just release the Super Mario Land Bar on Wii U.
Okay.
Now with the PlayStation 1. I played PlayStation 1 since I was a kid. A middle school kid. My dad got me one as a birthday gift. As my way of saying happy birthday to my entry as a 12-year-old or 13-year-old. I couldn't remember. But I never owned a PlayStation console. But at the time, my PlayStation 2 is compatible with PlayStation 1 and PlayStation and all the DVD, the other ones before DVDs. Well, I don't know. I could be wrong. So I'm gonna say what I got first. So, Mega Man S4, explosive graphics. Mega Man S4. It is my goodness, this is a game I enjoy playing it right after Mega Man S1 because I don't have a S2 and S3 at that time. That was enjoyable. It was, oh my goodness, I can see this. Look at this. It is, you can see that what it said in the back. I cannot say, great game. But that voice, the English voice acting was just, it just makes me laugh. I'm one of those players that loves, like, bad English dubs. And this is great. Oh, but it says great, it says. Yeah. Mega Man S5. It was originally explosive, catastrophic, imminent. I enjoyed this game, and it was gonna be Mega Man S5 as the last of a series before Mega Man Zero arrived, and they had to change it. The plot story is, you had to play it yourself. It's you would lose your mind on this. Mega Man S6. It's not as good as the Mega Man S4, S5, or the first five. To be a sack. It's basically what is going. It's a good game, but it's not as fun. Or it could have been fun, but the story, it was like, that one. I don't know why. I kind of miss Mega Man S series, I wish there was something that. Now I have to got something else on my picks. Mega Man 8. I played that on Mega Man Anniversary Collection. And this is the one I think this is the one I played. I played it on the Mega Man Anniversary Collection first, and I beaten it. But I'm not beating the original one first. Cardcaptor Sakura Tetris. It's Tetris with Cardcaptor Sakura on it. It's very enjoyable. And the Japanese voice acting was lovable too. Super Puzzle Pirate 2 Turbo. It kind of reminds me of Kirby Avalanche. With how you round a certain colored square and you just make a big avalanche as you make combos and stuff. It's, yeah, it's basically, with, that's what it is. Hmm. Wonder what that one's about. It's Cardcaptor Sakura. So, they're like RPGs, but it kind of is, in a way, in a way, Cardcaptor Sakura and PlayStation is like, it's like a games, but it's really different from what it's potentially going to be, and I think that was all, and honestly, I enjoyed it very much. These are the PlayStation 1 and Super Nintendo birth memories I got. I personally love Super Nintendo more in terms of the game library, but PlayStation also got one too, so they pretty much got the same. I wish Nintendo just got back to the Super Nintendo days with the NS or Dreamcast, as that matter. I don't know. So, hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks.